Hi everyone, how do you do? In this video, we will be taking a look at how to create a dependence dropdown list. But creating a dependent dropdown is one issue, and how to manage it in different situations is another issue. Today, not only I will show you how to create a dependent dropdown, but also I will explain how to manage it in a practical example. So without any further ado, let's get started. We have the sale amount of some clothing items, and I want to create a dependent dropdown list in these two cells. First, let me create my dropdown list for the headers. Select this cell and from the data tab, click on the data validation icon. I want to create a list, and these are my dropdown items. Click on OK. In this cell, I want to create a dropdown list that is dependent to the first dropdown. I want, if I choose clothing, I see these items in my dropdown. If I choose country, I see different countries in the dropdown. And if I choose payment, I can choose between these items. Can you tell me which function I have to use? I have to use XLOOKUP function. In this cell, I type equal XLOOKUP. My lookup value is this cell, comma. My lookup array is this range, comma. And for returning array, select the entire table, enter. As you see, the returning column is dependent to the dropdown content. If I choose different headers, I can see their subsets in the column, but the column is full of duplicates, and for the dropdown, we need the unique items. For solving this problem, we have to add a unique function in the first part of the formula. This function is going to extract unique items from the list. Close the parentheses, enter. Okay, now if I choose different headers, I can see their subsets here. The problem is solved. We created a dependent list. It is time to define it as a dropdown list. Select this cell and click on data validation. I want to create a list, and in the source section, you have to select the first cell of the unique array. For returning the entire array as dropdown list, add a hash sign at the end. Click on OK. The dependent dropdown list is created. If you choose different headers, you can see their subsets in the second dropdown list. But wait, we haven't done yet. We want to use these dropdowns in an example. We are going to filter the list based on these two dropdowns. Since we don't have anything to do with this column, I can hide it. Alright, it is time to type in the filter function. I type equal filter. I want to return the entire table, comma. In the include section, we have to define the condition. We want to filter the list if the closing items are equal to this cell, enter. You can see the results. If I, in a set of closing, select country, you can see different countries in the second dropdown list. But if I select India, we have a problem. The filter function only checks if the items in this column are equal to this cell. And India doesn't exist in the column, so we see the calc error. We have to fix this problem. We need to find a way if we change the headers in this cell to country, Excel can put this column in the include section of the filter function and should do the same for the payment column. Don't you think it is familiar? Instead of referencing one column in the include section, we have to use XLOOKUP function. I type equal XLOOKUP. My lookup value is this cell, comma. My lookup array is this range, comma. And return array is the entire table, Enter. As you know, this column is responsive to the headers in the dropdown list. It is time to replace this function with the column address in the include section of the filter function. Copy the function and replace it with that. Enter. Now everything is dynamic. If I select different items, you can see that the filter function updates automatically. We don't need this guiding column anymore. I can delete it. But if you look at the dropdown list precisely, we still have a small problem. When we change the header, I see calc error, and the item in the second dropdown cell doesn't belong to the selected header. I want to find a way if I change the header, don't see anything in the second dropdown cell, and instead of the calc error, I see a message. The calc error section is easy. Select filter function and add a comma at the end. And in the if empty argument section, type in quotation, please select an item from the second dropdown list, quotation, enter. Okay, now we need to find a way to hide the item in the second dropdown cell if we changed the header. First, let me unhide the unique column. If you notice, when we change the header, this item belongs to the previous header, and it doesn't exist in the unique array. I have to use this feature in my conditional formatting. I can use the COUNTIF function. I type equal COUNTIF. In the range section, I select unique items, comma, and for criteria, I select this cell, enter. Since there is no shared in this range, I get 0. If I select USA from the dropdown, I get number 1, which means there is one USA in the list. Alright, I have to cut this formula and paste it in the conditional formatting. Select this cell and from Home tab, click on the conditional formatting. Select New Rule and in the Opened window, select Use a Formula option. In this section, paste the formula. If you notice, Excel only formats the cell when the results of function is true. And I want to format the cell when the result of COUNTIF function is equal to 0. Click on the Format icon and from the Number tab, click on the Custom option. In this section, type in 3 semicolons. These semicolons will format the cell and will hide the cell content when the result of COUNTIF function is equal to 0. Click on OK. Do you see that? The item in this cell is hidden. And if I select a new item, since this item exists in this array, I can see it. If I change my header again, I can't see anything in this cell, and Excel shows me this message. Please select an item from the second dropdown list. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a big thumb up and subscribe to the channel. Alright, it was all for today's video. I'll see you next video.